GNAT Project Manager, Part 7, Production Build of the Application Layer. A release is delivered to two different groups of specialists, namely the software engineers in the development department and test engineers and domain experts in the test lab and pre-production environments. Up to this point, we've examined the release from the developer's perspective. We will now look inside the release to examine the set of project files that produce the libraries and executables used for test and production purposes. The application part of the subsystem consists of three modules, where module A contains four components. For visualization purposes, it is useful to use the hardware analogy where subsystem is an electronic cabinet or a rack within a cabinet. Module is a VME-type circuit board that plugs into a slot in the cabinet. And component is an electronic chip mounted on a circuit board. The purpose of each component-level project in the application layer is to create an executable image for use in production. For example, since problems are never debugged on the production system, the executable images do not contain debug information. Most assertions are turned off, the code is optimized for performance, and so on. To ensure a consistent build, the compiler and builder packages use switch settings defined in the abstract project shared production attributes, which is located in the root of drive R and imported into the standard project representing the component. A package can be defined by a renaming declaration to obtain attributes specified in a different project, and that is what we do for the compiler and builder packages. Note that by definition, an abstract project contains no sources. Production underscore config.adc is a file containing configuration pragmas such as pragma suppress, pragma warnings, and other compiler directives. Aggregate projects, which are an extension of the standard project paradigm, simplify the building of architectures that use modules and components as building blocks. The simplification occurs in that we only need one command to build an entire application. In addition, aggregate projects allow for very efficient builds due to the fact that GPR build has access to the sources of each component. Having this overview means duplicate work is avoided and parallel processing techniques can be used to fully exploit all available CPU cores. The issue of build efficiency is particularly important in large projects involving millions of lines of code. For example, if the nightly build process fails, then after someone has fixed the problem, the job must be restarted to run during working hours, and depending upon circumstances, this delay can be very expensive. Therefore, it pays to have the most efficient build environment possible, and that implies the use of aggregate projects. You might also want to consider installing a RAM disk in your build server. Here we see an example of a nested aggregate project, that is, aggregates of aggregates. This top-level project is everything it needs to build all executables contained in the application layer of the subsystem. And here's the command to create all application images in the subsystem and in the shortest possible time. Note the absence of switches. All the details are recorded in the hierarchy of project files under Application Aggregate. This is the end of Part 7.